Welcome to the Google Workspace Developer News, where we share what's new to the Google Workspace platform. We have 10 topics to cover, so let's get started. The getSheetById method has been added to AppScript's Spreadsheet class of the Spreadsheet service. This method enables you to get a sheet in a spreadsheet using its unique ID. You can now get and set the transparency of a Google Calendar event. Use this method to set whether an event is transparent, meaning the calendar shows as available during that time, or opaque, meaning the calendar shows as busy during that time. The getUrl method for the sellImage, sellImage Builder, and OverGridImage classes of AppScript Spreadsheet service has been deprecated. An image's source URL isn't available regardless of how the image is inserted into a spreadsheet. Don't want to miss out on any Google Workspace platform updates? Then hit that subscribe button right below this video. The Workspace Policy API is now generally available. With this launch, we have enabled administrators to programmatically access over 60 Google Workspace settings, streamlining how they audit and monitor their workspace environment. The open source Google Drive Picker web component is now published to NPM. The Google Drive Picker web component provides a convenient way to integrate the Google Picker API into your web applications. Web components are reusable, custom HTML elements that encapsulate their own functionality and styling, allowing developers to create modular and independent UI widgets that work in any web framework. Quick commands are a new way for users to invoke and interact with the chat app directly without typing a slash command. When a user invokes a quick command, the app is directly invoked without needing further inputs from the user, allowing for faster and more user-friendly interactions. This feature is available through the developer preview program. To respond to slash commands and quick commands, Google Chat apps must now use the app command payload instead of a message payload. This change only has an impact on chat apps that are built as Google Workspace add-ons, a new feature which is available through the developer preview program. To learn more about how to build Google Workspace add-ons that extend Google Chat, please find the link in the video description below. Available through the developer preview program, you can now design your chat app to include a carousel. Carousels show a collection of items that can be scrolled on and off the screen. You can nest widgets, such as images, text, or buttons within each carousel item. Available through the developer preview program, you can now create announcement spaces and update space permission settings using the chat API with app authentication. This enables chat apps to create announcement spaces and read and update space permissions. Through the developer preview program, more Google Workspace add-on UI widgets are now available. These are the same UI widgets that we made available for Google Chat apps back in August 2024. If you want to check out that announcement, click on the card that is displayed in the top right corner of this video right about now. Let us know in the comments section below. Which new feature are you most interested in trying out? Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in next month's news video.